All right, friends, we are inside the History Center. Jesse's lining up for a picture. Check out this artwork, though. Isn't that awesome? Come on, Jess. We'll get a picture real quick. Smile, cheese. All right, let's head on in to the museum and check it out. First thing I see is this staring us straight in the face. Look at it. How cool is that? Nice little wooden aircraft. Very, very neat. I have to say, this museum is huge. Very similar to the museum that was in Denver. This one is just as big. Hopefully, it's full of more content than the one in Denver was. The one in Denver we were very disappointed with. Gave it, I think, a 2.5 out of 5 so far. We'll see about this one. But Jesse's already finding plenty to take pictures of for you. So let's find the museum and we'll see you there. All right, friends, so we're going inside our very first exhibit. This is the Then and Now exhibit. Then, Now, and Wow exhibit. So come on in, let's check it out. First impressions, wow. Check all this out. I think this is the area primarily for youngsters, for kids to play around. However, I was told by the front desk that this is an all-age activity. By the way, this is a great time to mention it. If you're brand new to our channel and our content, make sure to subscribe and do give us a thumbs up. Those likes really do help our YouTube algorithm. So let's check out some of the activities here. Check out some of this, picking up the pieces of history. Check out this longboat. I don't know if you can tell it, but it's actually an Indian boat. It's a paddling machine is what it's called. But check out the painting on it. How cool is that? Absolutely awesome exhibit. And look at these guys. You gotta love our friendly beavers, right? All right, let's check out a little bit of the Iron Age. We're gonna step into the mining and see what that was all about. Oh. All right. Let's see. So check out some of this, look at the machinery and the tools. You get to touch them, you get to see them. I have to say, if you can't tell by the background around me, they really did a great job of making this look very realistic. Right, so this is an area where your kids can come, they can play around. As you can see here in the background, kids are playing around. They can come, they can pretend to blow up the mine, and whoa, that was awesome. That was one of the kids playing around. How cool was that though, the mine? Very, very authentic. I think the only thing missing was the musty smell. Here we are talking about the schools. So you have your lunch table back here, but going back in time, check out these school desks. I have to say, I don't know if I quite fit anymore. How cool is that though? I'm really liking a lot of the pictures, a lot of the murals. I really feel like the curator has done just a really good job with the layout of this museum so far. It is looking very nice, very neat. I've lost my wife as usual, but I still have you all. Check out these giant pair of snowshoes and the wall decor behind us. They're really trying to bring in a lot of the Native American side of Minnesota mixed in with what and who Minnesota is, here in the now. Check this out. I can only imagine what it took to bring a rail car onto the third floor of the museum. Yeah, we're on the third floor. That is That is absolutely crazy that they were able to bring this full size, look at it behind me, full size rail car. We're on the third floor. How crazy is that? Check this out, they even have classrooms for the kids. That is absolutely cool. Uh-oh. Animal lovers, go ahead, turn your head, look away. Look at this, check this out. Uh-oh. It's a poor one. He has died, and now the kids are about to devour him like the coyotes do. But, I mean, look at this behind us. I have to say, this is our very first exhibit, and it's really well done. You know, even all the way down, check this out, inside the teepee. Look at that. How cool is that? It's just a imaging, you know, as you can see as I move the camera around, but look at how cool it is. And this is inside the teepee. I have to say, if I was a kid, I'd be begging my parents to bring me here because they even have a streetcar. Absolutely awesome. Tons of things to see, to do here, and to learn about. I am wandering around everywhere looking for my wife. I do not see her. I think we've lost her for good. She has become a Minnesotan now. Sorry, guys. I guess you're stuck with me. All right, I'm gonna take you all to our next exhibit. I think we've kind of breezed through everything that there is to do here. I'm gonna try to find my wife, take you on to the next exhibit, and I will see you there. Look who I found, friends.
I got lost in the miners.
She was in the mine shaft.
I know, I got lost.
And she wasn't wearing her hard hat.
No.
I had on my hard hat. She was not wearing hers.
Which his is made out of paper, so.
Hey, they don't need to know that. Watch out, OSHA will be all over me for missing federal guidelines. All right, so what do you think of this first exhibit? What do you think for our viewers?
I like it.
You like it.
I do.
You heard it first here, people. She likes it.
I know.
2-star, 5-star?
What do we think? 2.5 stars.
2.5? For kids? Maybe a 3.
Maybe a 3 for kids.
Maybe a 3 for, yeah, for kids. 2.5 for adults.
Uh-huh.
All right. Let's head on over to our next exhibit. Check out some of these pictures that Jesse has been taking for you. All right, friends, hopefully you enjoyed the then, now, wow exhibit. Next, we're heading into the Greatest Generations exhibit. So let's go see what is in here. First thing I notice is a lot of noise.
It also has the Depression, the War, and the Boom. It's all in here.
Right on. Awesome. Uh-huh. All right, well, let's check it out. Sounds like there's a lot of fun happening in here. And yeah, I would agree. So here's one of the first things that I realize is there's tons of collections of things. You know, it's a museum of things, as you can see behind me. Check out all of the collections of just, you know, random period things that has happened. And if you're wondering what all the noise is, there you go. It's kids in a grocery store. They are serving up drinks. They're having a blast. Definitely a place to bring your kids. If you can't tell, if you think your kids are rowdy, hey, that's totally fine. None of the staff here cares. how loud they get. But yeah, check out all of the war memorabilia, all of the cool things that's going on. And check out this, they did not disappoint. They even brought in some of the big guns. Check that out. How cool is that? You know, I mean, I don't know if you can tell the scale behind me. How they got this stuff onto the third floor is really beyond me, but it is absolutely stunning. And check this out, ammunition in work. How cool is that? They're getting to load ammunition and make bullets. How cool, right?
Hi.
Hey, how are you? Check this out. You even have a counter counting down how many bullets that you can make. You load the round, it's a rubber round, right in there, and then send it through the machine. That is so cool. I have to say, this is a very interactive museum. You know, most museums that we've been to, they're very hands-off. You can't touch things. It's usually things that are behind a glass. Check this out behind us. Absolutely cool. You know, the period pieces that they have here in the kitchens, that is awesome. Check out this period piece car. I am telling you, so cool how they got all of these large pieces of machinery into this museum. You know, I am very much impressed. I think my 2.5 star is going up and up. I would rate it currently at a 3.5, and here's why: because of the interactivity. There is a lot of hands-on ability here at this museum. Everything just about is interactive, and that I think is very cool for museums to do. The more interactive they can make it, the better I think that younger generations are going to pick up the activities and learn more about the history. So let me find my wife, check out some of these pictures right here, and we will be back at our next exhibit. All right, friends, so hopefully you've really enjoyed this part of the exhibit. I think this was the Greatest Generations exhibit. Absolutely cool. Hopefully you enjoyed some of the pictures. Jesse's working really hard back here. Sorry for all the chaos. You know, you never know when you go to a museum whether or not there's going to be a lot of kids and, you know, school events, but hey, it is what it is. You just have to roll with the punches, right? So we are gonna head on to our next exhibit. We have to find it. This is a four-story museum, I believe, is what I saw. It's absolutely huge and definitely worth coming to check out if you are here in Minnesota. And by the way, that plane that we saw on the entrance, check it out right back there. How cool is that? All right, let's go find our next exhibit and we'll see you there. All right, friends, so we made it to our next exhibit. Check this guy out, giant snowman. This is the weather permitting exhibit. Now, here's a little insider information. On the map that the info desk gives you, it says weather permitting. I thought that meant actually weather permitting, you know, but no. Weather permitting means it's all about the weather. It's all about the outdoors here in Minnesota. And as you can see behind me, again, a lot like the other exhibits, this is very well done. I mean, check out this. You know, look at those trees, those details. Kind of looks like a 90s Disney, right? Oh yeah, did you miss the car right there? How cool is that? So let's explore around just a little bit and see some of this weather permitting area. Look at this. How cool is that? Absolutely stunning and beautiful. Oh, and look at this twister that we found right back here. Almost like the Wizard of Oz, right? That is a cool twister. And then, you know, it wouldn't be outdoors without water sports and a boat. How cool is that to have a full-size boat? And then look at all of these cute cute little windmill type things. I mean, I just have to say, this is so well done, and it's definitely an exhibit worth coming to see. I mean, look at the house destroyed by the tornado. There's, I don't know if you can tell, it's an upside down piano. How cool is that? Throughout each of these exhibits, they have documentary films that you can come and take a look at.
Ice palace at night. Is there an ice palace?
There is an ice palace, and apparently this is what it looks like.
Postponed 1890.
What does it say here? Yeah, it is.
It's like there's a winter carnival memories.
Aw. Uh-huh. 1935, winter carnival memories.
Little cocoa and some toast and stuff.
There you go.
Aww.
Yeah. So this area, from what I'm gathering from the pictures, we haven't spent time reading through the book, but it looks like a lot of winter games were held here back in the late 1800s, early 1900s. And apparently the ice castle looked just like this. Not sure if it's still standing today or where it would be. Let's see, Jesse, do you see?
It's a model.
Ice Palace model, okay.
Among 1.5 million people who visit the St. Paul Winter's Carnival.
Wow.
Ice Palace on Lake Phelan in 1986.
Wow. All right.
They spent 3,050 hours on this model.
Ooh, that's a lot of hours.
That's intense. And it includes 10,180 pieces of glass.
Wow.
And 1,270 lights on this.
That's quite impressive.
I guess it's... Oh,
wow.
Oh,
okay. Alright. Oh, now it's green.
Now it's turning green.
Okay, alright. Learn something new every day. Check it out. How cute is that? And now it's a Christmas color. Well, that is pretty cool. Snifty. Alright, so this is weather permitting. Hopefully you've enjoyed this exhibit. I think we have one or two exhibits left. By the way, if you're brand new to our channel, make sure to subscribe and do give us a thumbs up. Your support really does help. All right, on to our next exhibit. Check out some of these pictures now. All right, friends, hopefully you enjoyed weather permitting. Now we're heading into Greenland. Let's go check out this exhibit. Again, a definite kids exhibit. Look how fun and crazy this place is. But check this out. Oh, guess what? We made it right back into the exhibit we left from earlier. So it's not a new exhibit at all. It's just a room. All right, let's find my wife and let's go to our next exhibit, shall we? All right, friends, so we've made it to our final exhibit. This is our home, Native Minnesota. So let's go in here and check this out. This is definitely not a kids exhibit. This is the adults only section. It's so peaceful and quiet in here. How cool is that? But it definitely pays homage to a lot of the Native American history of Minnesota, which is so cool to see a lot of the memorabilia. Check out some of these things. Look at this. 1862. How cool is that? And as we make our way on around, again, we begin to see a lot of the Native artifacts to Minnesota that are period pieces. Very, very cool. And then let's look on this side. We have some of the drums and rugs from the Native America period. And then of course, paying homage to the Native Americans and then eventually the American settlers. Very, very neat displays and artifacts. And then we'll round out this episode with some period piece outfits. Check those out right back here. Now we're starting to get more into the museum feeling of what this actually is. How cool is this? So overall, I would definitely say probably rounding this out at a 3.5. Yeah, probably a 3 to a 3.5, mainly because it's so interactive. Hopefully there's more, but it looks like we've seen all of the exhibits so far. So if you like this episode, do give us that thumbs up, and we'll see you at the next Destination Unknown. In the meantime, check out some more pictures, and we'll see you in the next one.